Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to Grandma Teresa's Story Time. Today I will be reading Take Care, Good Night by Shelley Moore Thomas, pictures by Paul Measle. This comes from the Dolly Parton's Imagination Library. Once there were three little dragons. The dragons lived in a deep, dark cave that was in the king's forest. But the dragons were very happy in their cave. They had a good friend. He was called the Good Knight. Every day he rode his horse, clippity-clop, clippity-clop, to the dragons' cave to say, "Good morning, good dragons." "Good morning, good knight," replied the dragons. And every night he rode his horse, clippity-clop, clippity-clop, to put the little dragons to bed. "Good night." "Good night," the dragon said before they went to sleep. There they are in bed. And a good night is saying good night to them, isn't it? One day, after the good knight had ridden off on his horse, clippity-clop, the little dragons heard a knock on the door. It was another friend, the old wizard. "Good day, little dragons. I was wondering if you could help me," the old wizard said. "We will try," said the dragons. "I would like you to watch my cats while I go away for a few days. Can you do it?" Sounds like they're going to be taking care of the wizard's cats while he's away, doesn't it? The dragons had never watched cats before, but the good knight had taught them that it was good to do good deeds. "Certainly we will help you," said the dragons. The old wizard was very happy. He told the dragons that he would leave a note with instructions at his cottage. He left them the shiny silver key to his door. "Take care, good dragons," he said. And then he disappeared in a puff of smoke. "This is going to be fun," said the first dragon. "I can hardly wait," said the second dragon. "Yippee," said the third dragon. The next day, the dragons went to the wizard's cottage to take care of the cats. They opened a door with a shiny silver key. They saw lots of cats. They found the wizard's note on the counter. There was only one problem. The dragons didn't know how to read. Oh no, now what will happen? The dragons can't read the note on how to care for the cat. What do you think will happen next? Let's read on and find out, shall we? "I think the first thing we're supposed to do is take the cat swimming in the lake," said the first dragon. So the dragons gathered up the cats and took them to the lake for a swim. Oh my goodness. What will happen next? Read on. Just then, the good knight was riding by on his horse. "Good day, good dragon," said the good knight. "What are you doing?" "We are taking the wizard's cats for a swim," said the dragons. "He told us to." Cats swimming? That did not seem right. But if the old wizard said so, it must be true. "Very well," said the good knight. "Carry on." But the cats did not like swimming. They did not like it one bit. They howled and yowled. They quivered and shivered until... What do you think is going to happen next? The little dragons took them home. Then the little dragons looked at the wizard's note to see what to do next. "I think it says to put the cats in the cupboard, said the second dragon. So the dragons put the cats in the cupboard. Oh no, that's not a very good idea, is it? Putting cats in a cupboard? Oh my. Just then the good knight was riding by. What are you doing? Asked the good knight. We are putting the wizard's cats in the cupboard. He told us to. Cats in the cupboard? That did not seem right. But if the old wizard said so, it must be true. Very well, said the good knight. Carry on. But the cats did not like being in the cupboard. They did not like it one bit. They scritched and scratched until little dragons let them out. Oh my goodness.
Wow.
By then, the cats were very thirsty and very hungry, and so were the little dragons. But they looked at the note once more. I think now we are supposed to take the cats camping, said the third dragon. So the dragons took the cats out camping under the stars. Well, that doesn't sound too bad, does it? You can make s'mores. That sounds pretty fun, doesn't it? What are you doing? Asked the good knight, who was coming to bring the dragons back to their cave. We are taking the cats out camping, said the dragons. The old wizard told us to. Cats camping? That did not seem right. But if the wizard said so, it must be true. Very well, said the good knight. Carry on. But the cats didn't like camping. They didn't like it one bit. They jumped and bumped. They clawed and pawed. They cussed and fussed and hissed, and they would not even eat one toasted marshmallow. I like toasted marshmallows, don't you? Apparently the cats do not. The good knight could not help but hear all the racket the cats were making. Something doesn't seem right, he thought. Back he rode to the wizard's house, clippity-clop. Follow me, good dragons, he said. Let us get to the bottom of this and bring those cats. What do you think will happen now that they're taking the cats back to the house? Inside the wizard's house, the good knight found the wizard's note. It did not say to take the cats swimming. It did not say to put the cats in the cupboard or to take them camping. Didn't you read this note? He asked. The dragons hung their heads, their eyes filled with drippy, droppy tears. We told him we would take care, but we don't know how to read, they confessed. So the good knight read the note to the dragons. Now maybe if the dragons had just gone to the good knight in the beginning, there wouldn't have been a problem, would there? First, they gave the cats water. Then they fed the cats food from the cupboard. And they put the cats in their beds to sleep. By then, the dragons were very tired themselves. The good knight walked them back to their cave and tucked them in for the night. It would have been a tiring day for them dragons, wouldn't it? Taking care of the cats when you don't really know how to take care of them. The next day, the wizard came back from his trip. He visited the dragons. Thank you for watching my cats, he said. You did such a good job. I wanted you to have this. He handed them a tiny baby kitten of their own. And I wanted you to have this, said the good knight. He handed a book to the dragons. Oh, they received a kitten and a book. That was a nice surprise, wasn't it? it was a book about learning to read. The ABC book. Didn't I tell you that ABCs are important for reading? Isn't that right? How about we do the ABC song together? Would you like that? Okay. One moment, and we will do that. All right then, here we go. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Now I said my ABCs. Tell me what you think of me. Well, I think you're all very special in your own way. And until next time, stay safe and well. I know.